Hello students, this is Dr. A.S. Iyer from Sanjeevani College of Engineering, Kopparga. I welcome you all for this fifth lecture on finite element analysis. Since last four lectures, we are discussing about isoparametric formulation for the finite element analysis. In this lecture, we will discuss about Jacobian matrix, the important part of isoparametric formulation. In isoparametric formulation, we know that both the coordinate systems are used, Cartesian coordinate system as well as natural coordinate system, that is xy coordinate system and xi eta coordinate system. So during the isoparametric formulation, many times we have to differentiate Cartesian coordinates with respect to natural coordinates or natural coordinates with respect to Cartesian coordinates. So to find out this differentiation, Jacobian matrix is used. So if somebody asks you what is Jacobian matrix, what is the use of Jacobian matrix in isoparametric formulation, one can define very simply, Jacobian matrix is used to represent derivatives of Cartesian coordinates with respect to natural coordinates or derivatives of natural coordinates with respect to Cartesian coordinates. So we'll see now the standard derivation of Jacobian matrix with the help of simple quadrilateral. The statement of derivation is, derive Jacobian matrix for four noded isoparametric quadrilateral element as shown in figure. This is quadrilateral given with the coordinates x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, x4, y4. Node numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we know that the parent element or equivalent element of quadrilateral is 4-noded rectangular element. So very first step to derive the Jacobian matrix in isoparametric formulation, draw 4-noded rectangular element. The sequence of node numbers given, 1, 2, 3, 4, anti-clockwise same. So this is first node, 1, 2, 3, 4. Give the node numbers to rectangular element. Coordinates we know that minus 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, 1 and minus 1, 1. So first step, draw parent element, 4-noded rectangular. Then write down shape functions for the rectangular element. Node number 1, so this is N1. N2, N3, N4. We know that to write down the shape functions, xi eta use or follow the signs of coordinates. So shape function of node number 1, 1 minus xi, 1 minus eta upon 4. Shape function of node number 2, 1 plus xi, 1 minus eta upon 4. 1 plus xi, 1 plus eta upon 4, N3. And N4 is equal to 1 minus xi, 1 plus eta upon 4. So second step, write down 4 shape functions of 4 nodes. Now we know that in case of isoparametric formulation, displacements are represented in terms of shape functions. So displacement equations are u and v. U and v are the displacements of any point in the quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is a two-dimensional element. So there are two displacements, displacement in x direction and displacement in y direction. So displacement in x direction, u is equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 u3 plus n4 u4. Similarly, displacement in y direction, v is equal to n1 v1 plus n2 v2 plus n3 v3 plus n4 v4. Third step is write down displacements in terms of shape functions. Now, next step is, if you want to find out strains in the quadrilateral element, strain displacement relation, we have already discussed in unit number 1, theory of elasticity. Strains can be determined if displacements are known. So strain displacement relations are, epsilon x is equal to du by dx, epsilon y equal to dv by dy, and gamma xy is equal to du by dy plus du by dx. Du by dy plus dv by dx. These are the strains. Now if you want to find out strains, epsilon x is equal to du by dx, differentiate u with respect to x. U is known to us, u is equal to n1 u1 to n4 u4, where N1 to N4 are the functions of xi eta. So u and v are the functions of xi eta, but in space we require derivatives of shape functions with respect to x and y. dN1 by dx, dN2 by dx in epsilon y. Similarly, dN1 by dy, dN2 by dy in epsilon y. So u and v are the functions of xi eta, and we require derivatives with respect to x and y. So if you want to differentiate u with respect to x, it means right hand side you have to differentiate with respect to x. On right hand side, u1, u2, u3, u4 are the nodal displacements which are constant. It means if you want to differentiate u with respect to x, you have to differentiate n1 to n4 with respect to x. Similarly, if you want to differentiate v with respect to y, you have to differentiate n1, n2, n3, n4 with respect to y. Because v1, v2, v3, v4 are the nodal displacements constant. So, first strain, epsilon x is equal to, which is du by dx, derivative of u with respect to x means dn1 by dx, u1 as it is, plus dn2 by dx, u2 plus dn3 by dx, u3 and dn4 by dx, u4. So epsilon x is equal to first differentiate shape functions with respect to x. Similarly, epsilon y is equal to derivative of v with respect to y. Derivative of v with respect to y means right hand side differentiated with respect to y. So derivatives of shape functions with respect to y and v1 to v4 as it is. So epsilon y is equal to derivative of n1 with respect to y, n2 with respect to y, n3 with respect to y and n4 with respect to y. Then gamma xy is equal to derivative of u with respect to y. So here if you differentiate u with respect to y means n1 to n4 are differentiated with respect to y. And v with respect to x means n1 to n4 are differentiated with respect to x. So gamma xy equation is first four terms are from u, dn1 by dy, u1 plus dn2 by dy into u2 up to dn4 by dy, u4. Similarly, v with respect to x means dn1 by dx into v1, dn2 by dx into v2 up to dn4 upon dx into v4. So like this you have to find out strain quantities. Now if you observe the strain equations, here shape functions are differentiated with respect to x and y. And actually shape functions are functions of xi and eta. It means shape functions are given in terms of xi eta, but we have to differentiate shape functions with respect to x and y. So here we have to use chain rule of the derivative of composite functions to find out the derivatives of shape functions with respect to x and y. So chain rule, we know that we have already learned in mathematics 1 how to find out shape functions, how to find out derivatives of composite function. So initially shape functions are functions of xi eta. Initially shape functions are functions of xi eta, but we require derivatives of shape functions with respect to x, y to calculate these strains. So we require derivatives with respect to x, y. So to find out derivative, we have to use chain rule. We have to use chain rule of composite function. So let us assume n subscript I, where I is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. It may be n1, n2, n3, n4. So derivative of shape function with respect to x. Derivative of shape function with respect to x is equal to derivative of shape function with respect to xi, xi with respect to x. Derivative of shape function with respect to xi, xi with respect to x. Plus derivative of shape function with respect to eta, eta with respect to x. This is derivative of shape function with respect to x. Similarly, derivative of shape function with respect to y is equal to derivative of shape function with respect to xi, xi with respect to y, plus derivative of shape function with respect to eta, eta with respect to y. So like this you have to find out shape functions of derivatives of shape functions with respect to x and y using chain rule. If these two equations if you write down in matrix form, if you write down same two equations in matrix form, left hand side derivative of shape functions with respect to x and y, then column vector of derivative of shape functions with respect to xi and eta, and these coefficients you have to write down in matrix form, derivative of xi with respect to x, eta with respect to x, xi with respect to y, eta with respect to y. So this 2 by 2 matrix is called as inverse of Jacobian matrix. Jacobian is represented by matrix J, and this is actually inverse of Jacobian matrix. So if you want to find out Jacobian matrix, simply you have to take reciprocal of all these four terms to find out the Jacobian matrix. So finally, Jacobian matrix J is equal to, simply take reciprocal of these four terms. So it is dx by dz, dx by d eta, dy by dz, and dy by d eta. So this is called as Jacobian matrix, 2 by 2 Jacobian matrix. If you observe carefully the Jacobian matrix, where you will get derivatives of x and y, that is Cartesian coordinates with respect to xi and eta, natural coordinates. So it means Jacobian matrix is used to find out derivatives of Cartesian coordinates with respect to natural coordinates. So if a question is asked in the examination on derive the standard Jacobian matrix for four-moded isoparametric quadrilateral element, this much you have to write down. But if a numerical example is asked on Jacobian matrix, if coordinates of quadrilateral are given to you, in that case directly use this matrix and find out these four elements of Jacobian matrix in a numerical example. Okay, so this is your Jacobian matrix for the isoparametric formulation. In the next lecture, we'll see the numerical example on Jacobian matrix. If a coordinates of quadrilateral are given, how to find out Jacobian matrix. Okay? Thank you. Thank you.